Okay, so in last two lectures and three practical sessions, we had learned basics of embedded system, how to start, what are the software required, what hardware you will need to do all those things. Then we learned what is the interrupts inside your microcontroller. We had learned about two different type of interrupts, external interrupt and timer based interrupt. Okay, then we did practical on all those things. We build a robot using ADC and few more features of microcontroller. Okay, so actually this was the complete course content of this session. Today we will learn few extra things which is related to embedded system, as we will have a break in between the lecture. In the first part we will teach you few basic things, and in second part we will learn about GPS and GSM modules. Okay, so before starting, if you have any question, you can ask. Any confusion, any question regarding whatever you have done in last lectures or practical sessions? No. Okay, so let's start from beginning. We had seen in the start of lecture, we had seen that there is an architecture called ABR. Based on that, this architecture, Atmel company manufacture few microcontrollers. Out of those microcontrollers, we had selected a microcontroller named Atmega 16, on which we had done all these three practical sessions, and we had learned about few features of Atmega 16. But as I had told you in the first lecture, after this session or after this complete training program, we are not going to learn only about Atmega 16. We are going to learn about the complete family of ABR microcontrollers. So I am going to give a small introduction of the other microcontrollers which are from Atmega family. Okay. So these are the microcontrollers which are from Atmega family: Atmega 8, Atmega 16, Atmega 32, Atmega 64, Atmega 128. So let's see what is the difference between all these three things. What are these 8, 16, 32, 64 and 128? Okay, Atmega 8, the smallest member of this Atmega family with 28 pins, you will find port B, port C and port D on this microcontroller, no port A. On port C also, you will have only 6 pins. C0, C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, no C6, no C7, okay. So only this much pins are there on Atmega 8. You will have all those features like interrupt, timer, with very small difference with Atmega 16, okay. ADC, as we don't have port A, they have shifted ADC to port C. Okay, on Atmega 8, you will find ADC on port A. As we have only six pins, we can connect Atmega 6 analog device to this microcontroller, Atmega 8. Okay, we have only 6 connections for ADC. Next, Atmega 16, you know, 40 pins, 4 ports, 8 pins in on all ports. We have ADCs, timer and everything we already know. Atmega 32, exactly similar to Atmega 16. There is no difference. There is only one difference which I will explain in next part. Okay, Atmega 64 will have 64 pins, will have 8 ports, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, 7 ports, okay, up to G. I think G have only 3 or 4 pins, but there are 7 ports. So exactly similar to port A, port B, port C, port D in Atmega 16, you can also program port E, F and G. Okay. In Atmega 64, you will have 2 ports for ADCs. I don't know which ports, but there are 2 ports which you can use for ADC. Okay, so there are 16 ADCs. You will have more interrupts, more external interrupts. We have more pins, so more external interrupts. Next, UART. On Atmega 16, we had seen there are one UART connections, one RX, one TX. On Atmega 64, you will find two ADCs, two UARTs. Okay, so you will have two RX, two TX. Okay, Atmega 128, exactly similar to Atmega 16. No difference except one, which I am going to explain. Next, this 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. These are size of flash memory inside your microcontroller in KBs. It means Atmega 8 have 8 kilobytes of memory, flash memory inside it. Okay. Flash memory is a memory where you write your hex file. Whenever you generate hex file after compilation, you transfer that hex file from computer to microcontroller. That hex file goes to this flash memory. Flash memory is similar to hard disks inside your microcontroller. Okay? वो exactly आपके computer में जो hard disks होता है उसी के तरह होता है. Next, RAM. Inside all these microcontrollers, we will also find RAM. Like in Atmega 8, अच्छा हाँ मैं अभी flash पे था. So Atmega 8 have 8 kilobyte, 16 has 16 kilobyte, and 128 have 128 kilobytes of flash. Now you may find a microcontroller named Atmega 816 or Atmega 168. Means you will find two different numbers like 8 and 16 on same name. Okay, whenever you will find a microcontroller like this, Atmega 168 or Atmega 816, it means this microcontroller have two different features of two different microcontroller. Atmega 168 means it's a Atmega 16, it's a Atmega 8 with 16 kilobyte of memory. Clear? Atmega 168 means 16 kilobyte of memory, but it will have other features similar to Atmega 8. Okay, so first number will represent the flash memory, size of flash memory of microcontroller, and the second number will represent the other features of microcontroller. Clear? So you can have multiple combinations like 64, 32. I don't know what combinations are available in market, but you can have different combination. Okay, now to transfer a code from computer to microcontroller, on each microcontroller you will find four pins: MISO, MOSI, SCK, RESET. You need to connect these four pins to your USB Tini or any programmer. If you will purchase any programmer called ISP, in system programmer. In system programmer means the main programmer is actually inside my microcontroller. We use an interface just to use that programmer. Okay, so any ISP based programmer, if you will purchase any ISP based programmer from market, it will have four wires: MISO, MOSI, SCK, RESET. You need to connect those four wires to same wires on microcontroller. Clear? Next, in Eclipse, you need to do settings for that programmer accordingly. If you will purchase USB ASP, in Eclipse also, you need to specify USB XP in programmer part. Okay. Next, in case of Atmega 16 and 128, there is a small difference. Instead of MISO and MOSI, they use a pin called DO and DI, data out and data in. For MOSI, master output, they use data out pin. For MISO, master input, they use ulta ho gaya. For MOSI, master output, they use data input pins. Okay, while programming, your computer is out master and your microcontroller is called slave. Okay, so for MISO, master output, slave input, they use data input pins. Okay, and for MOSI, they use data other pin. Okay, so be careful when you are using Atmega 64 or 128. Next, there are two formats of these microcontrollers, physical format. One which you have seen, big size, 40 pins. Okay, you might have seen a small chip on motherboard. जिसमें ढेर सारी छोटी 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 टांगे होती है. दैट फॉर्मेट इज कॉल्ड एस एम डी, सरफेस माउंट डिवाइसेस. ओके, ऑल दीज माइक्रो कंट्रोलर्स आर ऑल्सो अवेलेबल इन एस एम डी फॉर्मेट. ऑल दीज माइक्रो कंट्रोलर्स आर ऑल्सो अवेलेबल इन एस एम डी फॉर्मेट, लाइक एटमेगा 8. इन केस ऑफ डिप फॉर्मेट, डिप मीन्स बड़ा वाला जो हमने देखा, इट्स अ 28 पिन चिप. बट इफ यू विल गो फॉर एस एम डी, इट विल बी अ 32 पिन चिप. The difference will be the new chip, the new SMD chip will have more VCC and more ground pins. Nothing special. Okay, उसमें VCC और ground pins की संख्या बढ़ जाती है. At Mega 16, it will get converted into 44 pins. At Mega 32, again 44 pins, क्योंकि दोनों में कोई difference नहीं है, 16 and 34. At Mega 64 and 128. These two microcontrollers are only available in SMD format, no DIP format. DIP format में चिप बनाई जाती है तो बड़ी सी चिप हो जाती है. But they are not manufacturing any Atmega 64 and 128 in DIP format. So it's available only in SMD format. To use SMD format, you must have a printed PC, printed circuit board, or I should say PCB. So that you can solder it on that diagram, then only you can use it. Okay, जैसे Atmega 16 में आपने लिया, कुछ नहीं मन किया तो direct उसके pin पे एक wire solder करके भी you can use it. But in case of SMD format, it's not possible to solder a wire on their pins. Clear? You will also find a microcontroller called Atmega 8L, Atmega 16L, Atmega 32L, Atmega 64L, Atmega 128 in market. The difference between this L and without L is Atmega 16 works fine between a voltage from 4.5 volt to 5.5 volt. 4.5 volt से 5.5 volt के बीच ये perfect काम करता है. Atmega 16, Atmega 8, Atmega 32, Atmega 64 and Atmega 128. These microcontrollers works between a voltage 4.5 to 5.5. But this Atmega 8L, Atmega 16L, Atmega 32L, 64L with L, these microcontrollers works fine between 2.8 to 5.5 volt. Voltage range नीचे की ओर बढ़ जाता है और लोअर वोल्टेजेस पे आप वर्क कर सकते हैं. नाउ द यूज ऑफ दीज माइक्रो कंट्रोलर्स, देयर आर फ्यू डिवाइसेस एक्चुअली इन डिजिटल टेक्नोलॉजी. देयर आर ओनली, वी हैव ओनली टू थिंग्स, जीरो एंड वन. ऑलमोस्ट एवरीवेयर जीरो इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय जीरो वोल्ट, बट वन इज नॉट अ डिफाइंड थिंग. इन केस ऑफ कंप्यूटर यू विल फाइंड वन इज इक्वल टू 1.8 वोल्ट. In case of few chips, you will find it 2.8 volt. In few chips like microcontrollers, it's 5 volt. It may vary with devices. Okay, so if you want to interface a device with 1 equal to 2.8 volt, you need to run your microcontroller at 2.8 volt. So in that case, we use Atmega 8L, 16L or these microcontrollers. Okay, now. Then why can't you use only these microcontrollers, not without L? The problem is the microcontroller with L can run only up to 8 megahertz. ये कंप्यूटर है, इसकी अलग अलग फ्रीक्वेंसी पे आप रन कर सकते हैं. द अपर लिमिट ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ दीज माइक्रोकंट्रोलर्स विथ एल इज 8 MHz. सो यू कांट रन दीज माइक्रोकंट्रोलर्स अबव 8 MHz. बट दोज अदर माइक्रोकंट्रोलर्स विदाउट एल कैन बी ऑपरेटेड अबव 8 MHz. इट्स लिमिट इज 16 MHz. नाउ प्रॉब्लम कम्स विथ USB devices. If you want to design a, give me on USB tiny. If you want to design a USB device, if you want to design a USB device, you must run it at 12 MHz for USB 2.0. To interface any device with USB 2.0, you must run it at 12 MHz. USB की defined frequency है 12 MHz. So if you will use this microcontroller with L, it will not be possible to design a device to interface with USB port. Now, this device we have prepared with one microcontroller, AVR microcontroller. This black color cover, जिसके अंदर आपने कुछ देखा नहीं क्या है, okay, have one microcontroller named ATtiny2313. Okay, this is also a AVR family microcontroller, which we use to convert this USB communication to ISP, in system programmer communication. We call it ISP. It's SPI, but for specific purpose, we have a new name called ISP. Okay, so in this case, what we need is we need to run this microcontroller at 12 MHz. Agar main L wala use karunga, it will not work. ओके, फॉर ऑल माइक्रोकंट्रोलर्स आप एट मेगा की ले रहे हैं ATtiny की ले ले या कोई और भी AVR के माइक्रोकंट्रोलर, दीज फीचर्स आर सेम. L है तो इट कैन रन अप टू 8 MHz, अगर L नहीं है तो इट कैन रन अप टू 16 MHz. अगर L है तो लोअर वोल्टेज पे काम करेगा, अगर नहीं है तो इट विल नॉट वर्क एट लोअर वोल्टेज. क्लियर. कुछ दिन पहले तक हम लोग यूज करते थे USB ASP, एग्जैक्टली सिमिलर चिप होती है, थोड़ी सी डिफरेंस आ जाता है, नाम चेंज हो जाता है, ड्राइवर्स चेंज हो जाते हैं. इट्स कॉल्ड USB ASP, दैट इज डिजाइंड विथ ATmega 8. जो आपका ATmega 8 है हमने देखा, उस ATmega 8 का यूज करके बनाते हैं. दैट ऑल्सो रन एट 12 MHz. USB से कोई भी इंटरफेस करने वाली डिवाइस अगर बनानी हो तो यू मस्ट यूज रन इट एट 12 MHz. नाउ फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ दिस माइक्रोकंट्रोलर, whenever you will purchase any microcontroller, any AVR microcontroller from market, by default the microcontroller will run at 1 MHz. आप मार्केट से खरीद के लाएंगे, इसकी डिफॉल्ट फ्रीक्वेंसी 1 MHz होती है. ओके, नाउ इफ यू वांट यू कैन चेंज द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ दिस माइक्रोकंट्रोलर to options called 2 MHz, 4 MHz, 8 MHz. Do we have option for 16? No. So we have options for 1 MHz, 2 MHz, 4 MHz, 8 MHz. Okay, as you have seen, we haven't used any external crystal to provide these clocks. Actually, inside your microcontroller we have a RC oscillator. RC oscillator sabhi jante hain. It is used to generate a square wave. Inside our microcontroller, we have a RC oscillator of 8 MHz. Clear? Which is used to run this microcontroller. Other than that RC oscillator, we have dividers. Using that dividers, we can divide it into 4 MHz, 2 MHz and 4 MHz. I will teach you how to select or change the frequency of that microcontroller. Okay. But there is a small problem with RC oscillator. The frequency of RC oscillator depends on R and C. And this R and C is a function of time and temperature. Kisi bhi material ka resistance temperature ke saath change kar jata hai, capacitor ka change kar jata hai. Okay, so if you will measure the frequency of your microcontroller, it will never be equal to 8 MHz or 4 MHz or 1 MHz. It may be possible that you will have an error up to 25%. Okay, so if you will make a clock, it may run at 25% higher speed or 25% lower speed. So if you want to design a device with exact frequency like this device, ये 12 megahertz पे चलता है, अगर इसकी frequency 11.999 megahertz कर दी जाए, computer will not be able to detect this. Okay, so I must have a option. I must have a option to generate or to get a exact frequency, exact defined frequency. For that, we use external crystal. We had two pins in first lecture called XX. Those two pins are used to connect a external crystal to your microcontroller. Clear? Using those two pins, we can connect a external crystal to our microcontroller. But if you will connect it, the microcontroller will not run at external crystal. You need to make some changes inside your microcontroller so that it can use external microcontroller as a clock source. Okay? Agar aapne microcontroller liya, usme externally laga diya, it will not work. But be careful while changing the option to external microcontroller, external crystal. Once you will change it to external crystal, it will start working on external crystal. But if you haven't installed an external crystal on your microcontroller will not run. Kyunki aapne settings mein kya kar diya hai? To run at external crystal. And you haven't connected any external crystal, the microcontroller will not run. Uske baad ab setting reverse bhi nahi ki ja sakti hai without any crystal, kyunki microcontroller utne time ke liye dead hai. When you will connect a external crystal on those two pins, it will start working. Then only you can change the option from external to internal. Clear? So it may be possible कि आपने external में change कर दिया और आपने crystal नहीं लगाया, crystal loose connected है, and you will say कि microcontroller खराब हो गया. It doesn't mean कि microcontroller खराब हो गया. It only means कि आपने external पे set कर दिया और external clock से नहीं मिल रहा है. Okay. पहले memory थी. Now coming to memory. There are three types of memory available inside your microcontroller called Flash, SRAM, EEPROM. Okay. Flash memory is a memory where your code will get stored. Okay. While your code is running, you can't make changes in flash memory. Okay. But you can read it. If you want ki aap, like in sub cases aapko bahut jyada information store karne ki zarurat padti hai, like if you want to make a display, like station pe aapne display dekha hai laga hua rehta hai, if you want to design a display like this, yahan laga hua hai. Okay, if you want to design this display using your microcontroller, you need to store all those texts. Let's say aap puri story print karna chahte hain, this will scroll the complete story, but if you want to store, you need to store complete story inside your microcontroller also. You have RAM of size 1 kilobyte only. So what you will like, ki ha mujhe agar flash memory mil jaye, main sare information waha store kar lu, it will be good. Okay, to store information on flash memory, we need to do two things. Your variable must be constant. So, aap apna variable char I ke jagah CONST laga denge. Second, you need to write one more word in front of your variable to indicate that I want to write this variable on flash memory called PROGMEM. Okay, jo ki maine bataya hoga us samay jab hum variable apna character create kar rahe the on display. Okay. To read that memory, you can directly read your variable. Okay? Will it work now? You can directly, no. PGM, achha. To read that data from your memory, from that flash memory, you need a specific function, jiske baare mein main abhi thodi der mein bataunga. Okay? Next, SRAM. SRAM is a default memory.
for your data. Data means all your global variables, all your local variables. Whenever you will create a global variable, सबको पता है global variable, local variable क्या होता है ना? Whenever you will create a global variable, it will capture some space from your SRAM. Okay, but if you will create a local variable, it will not capture any memory from SRAM. But while running code, that local variable will use blank space of SRAM. Okay, now whenever you are compiling your code, last two sections you will see program 38% something and data 2% something. This program 28% means after transferring your code from computer to microcontroller, your flash memory will be filled up to 28%, and that data 2% means you have created 2% of global variables. Okay, if your flash memory is 100% full, no problem, clear, kuch dikkat nahi hogi, it will work fine. But if your SRAM is 100% full, means aapne apne SRAM ko global variable se fill kar diya hai, now you will not have space for your local variables. Local variables jo aapne create kiya hai uske liye koi jagah nahi bachegi. What will happen? The code will get stuck, wo run nahi karega. So after compiling your code, you must check that your SRAM is not 100% full. It may be possible ki aapne 99% fill kar diya hai to bhi na run kare. That will depend how many local variables you are creating, clear. So be careful about this SRAM, कि उसकी साइज कितनी फिल हुई है और हमें कितनी की रिक्वायरमेंट है. देयर इज नो एग्जैक्ट मेथड टू कैलकुलेट कि कितने में काम करेगा कितने में काम नहीं करेगा. इट मे बी पॉसिबल कि आपने 50% ही फिल किया है, देन ऑल्सो इट्स विल गेट स्टक. ओके, लास्ट ईई प्रोम. टिल नाउ आपने देखा होगा व्हेनेवर यू आर राइटिंग अ कोड, लेट्स से यू हैव रिटन अ कोड फॉर काउंटर, दैट पर्सन काउंटर इन दिस रूम, कोई आता है जाता है आता जाता है, इट्स काउंटिंग कैसे कर रहा है, देयर इज अ वेरिएबल कॉल आई जिसकी वैल्यू बढ़ जाती है और घट जाती है, क्लियर. नाउ लेट्स से आपके डिवाइस का पावर कट हो गया, इट्स रीस्टार्ट, इट विल रीस्टार्ट, क्या होगा, इट विल अगेन स्टार्ट आई फ्रॉम जीरो. ओके, टू अवॉइड दिस प्रॉब्लम, ऐसा क्यों होता है, बिकॉज माई आई इज स्टोर्ड इन रैम मेमोरी, एंड वी नो कि रैम इज अ टेम्पररी मेमोरी, जब भी पावर कट होता है सब सारा इंफॉर्मेशन चला जाता है, इट विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम जीरो. सो इन फॉर दैट कंडीशन माई आई मस्ट बी ऑन अ परमानेंट मेमोरी, जहां की बिजली पावर कट होने के बाद भी द वैल्यू ऑफ आई शुड रिटेन. ओके, फॉर दैट वी यूज अ मेमोरी कॉल्ड ईई प्रोम. ओके, ईई प्रोम इज अ मेमोरी ऑन विच वी कैन स्टोर अ वेरिएबल जो कि पावर कट होने के बाद भी वहीं रहेगा. ओके, इफ यू विल स्टार्ट द माइक्रोकंट्रोलर अगेंस्ट, आपके उसने काउंट करके 16 कर रखा है, इट विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 16, क्लियर. सो फॉर दैट पर्पस वी यूज ईई प्रोम, इट्स अ परमानेंट मेमोरी इनसाइड बाय माइक्रोकंट्रोलर विच कैन बी रिटेन ड्यूरिंग द कोड इज रनिंग. फ्लैश इज ऑल्सो अ परमानेंट मेमोरी, बट जब कोड रन हो रहा है यू कांट चेंज इट, देयर इज अ स्पेशल टेक्निक टू चेंज इट, बट वो हम लोग नहीं कवर कर रहे हैं. ओके, रीसेट के बारे में सबको पता ही होगा. वेन एवर यू विल प्रेस द रीसेट, व्हाट इट विल डू, इट विल स्टॉप द कोड एंड इट विल वेट फॉर समवन टू राइट इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम आउटसाइड डिवाइस टू इनसाइड योर माइक्रोकंट्रोलर. एंड वेन एवर यू विल रिलीज दिस रीसेट, इट विल स्टार्ट रनिंग द कोड रिटेन इन फ्लैश मेमोरी. Next, whenever you will purchase a microcontroller from market, there is a feature called JTAG. By default, this feature will be enabled inside your microcontroller. this is a feature, this is a feature which is little bit similar to your ISP. ISP means it is used to make communication between computer and microcontroller to transfer code for other things. JTAG is little bit similar to that ISP. JTAG is also used to transfer a code from computer to microcontroller, as well as it is also used to for debugging. Means when you want to debug your code, you can connect your computer to microcontroller using JTAG. Usme kuch interface hote hain computer pe, jispe ki aapko screen pe dikhai deta hai ki andar microcontroller ke andar kya ho raha hai. Okay. JTAG, for JTAG, we have four pins on our microcontroller: C2, C3, C4, C5. Okay. But there is a small problem. If JTAG is in enable condition, these four pins C2, C3, C4, C5 can't be used for other purpose. Like humne abhi C port pe apna display lagaya tha, you can't connect your display on C port. Why? Because these four pins will not work. So by default JTAG enable condition mein hota hai, so you will not be able to use those four pins in case of Atmega 16 and 32. If you have other microcontroller, if you have some other microcontroller, it may be possible ki wo kisi aur pins pe ho, like in Atmega 8 JTAG hota hi nahi hai. Clear? So jin bhi pins pe JTAG honge, wo pins disabled hote hain by default. To use those pins, you need to disable this JTAG. Like maine jo microcontroller aapko diya hai during practical session, unme JTAG disable kiye hue. That's why complete C port is working fine. Okay, so if you will purchase a microcontroller from market, usko aap use karne ki koshish karenge to C port pe thodi problem aayegi. Those four pins will not work. Okay, so you need to disable JTAG. We will teach you how to disable that JTAG. Aur kuch? Acha, data sheet. For each microcontroller or for each chip, all companies design a file, very big file called data sheet. For Atmega 16 also, you will find a file of pages around 400, less than 400, called data sheet of Atmega 16. In that file, you will find all technical detail of microcontroller. Technical detail means only technical details, no any user interface or user related thing. Like, aap kaise program karenge, ye kahin nahi likha hua hoga. Uske baare mein ye likha hoga ki MISO, MOSI aur SCK ka use karke code andar kaise jata hai. Bahar, from where you will generate those code, how you will transfer, no description about that. ADC kaise kaam karta hai, ye likha hoga, par how you can use ADC, ye kahin nahi likha hoga. Okay, so you will find all those technical details, all the features ki microcontroller ki kis frequency pe chalti hai, usme kitna error hota hai, what are the other things which will you can use, jo ki hum logon ne nahi padha hai. Okay, now this is the complete microcontroller you have seen. Jisme se hum logon ne kya kya seekh liya. Port A, port B, port C, port D, all these things we have learned. ADC, 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 all these things we have learned. On port C, we haven't learned anything other than CCC feature. These features we haven't learned. Here, port D, we have learned RxD, TxD, INT0, INT1. These four features we have learned. Other four features we haven't learned. Here, this T0 is the pin. T0 is a pin for external clock to timer 0. Timer 0 ko external clock se bhi chalaya jata hai. So this T0 pin is for external clock for timer 0. XCK, UART, aapne sikha? There is one more protocol called USART. Okay, in that protocol, clock pin phir se aa jata hai. It's exactly UART plus that clock pin. For that clock pin, this XCK is used. Okay, in case of USART, jo clock pin aayega, wo ye XCK hota hai. Clear? If you will find somewhere ki USART mil gaya aapko, to aapko confused nahi hona hai. Just connect the clock pin to this pin and it will work. Nothing special. Interrupt 2, MOSI, MISO, SCK. These three pins we know. Other than that, we haven't learned anything. This is the DIP format, SMD format of same microcontroller. You can see ki sare pins same hai except VCC ground, VCC ground, VCC ground, VCC ground. Extra VCC grounds hote hain. Now, let's assume ki aapne ghar mein ek microcontroller khareed ke laya. If you want to start, aur aapke paas ye nahi hai, and this is not easily available in market. Aap kisi company similar to Bricks ko contact karke ye khareed sakte hain. Otherwise, ye open market mein available nahi hota hai. Open market mein jo available hote hain, wo bahut mahange aate hain, like STK 500 cost 6500. ठीक है, उनकी कॉस्ट बहुत हाई होती है. तो नॉर्मल मार्केट में जो अवेलेबल है वो बहुत महंगे होते हैं, और जो सस्ते वाले होते हैं वो या तो लोग घर में डिजाइन करते हैं, खुद डिजाइन करते हैं, खुद यूज करते हैं, या फिर हमारे जैसी कोई कंपनी है वो बनाकर बेचती है. ओके, दिस इज द चीपेस्ट ऑप्शन टू ट्रांसफर अ कोड फ्रॉम कंप्यूटर टू माइक्रो कंट्रोलर. कैन यू सी व्हाट इज दिस? पैरेलल पोर्ट. पैरेलल पोर्ट सबने देखा कंप्यूटर के पीछे होता है, 25 पिन कनेक्टर. दिस इज दैट 25 पिन पैरेलल पोर्ट. हियर माइक्रोकंट्रोलर पिन्स मोसी मीसो एससीके रीसेट ग्राउंड, नो ऑप्शन फॉर वीसीसी. इस पोर्ट पे वीसीसी का कोई ऑप्शन नहीं होता है, सो यू नीड टू गिव अ वीसीसी और पावर सप्लाई फ्रॉम एक्सटर्नल बैटरी. क्लियर? नाउ जस्ट बाय कनेक्टिंग अ वायर मोसी टू पिन नंबर 7, मीसो टू पिन नंबर 10, एससीके टू पिन नंबर 6, रीसेट टू पिन नंबर 9, ग्राउंड टू पिन नंबर 25 और एनी आउट ऑफ दिस 21 22 23 25, ऑल दीज आर ग्राउंड पिन्स. बाय ओनली मेकिंग दीज 5 पिन्स 5 कनेक्शन विदाउट एनी रेजिस्टेंस. रेजिस्टेंस इसमें दिखाए गए हैं, बट नो नीड टू यूज रेजिस्टेंस. डायरेक्ट वायर्स लिए एंड यू कैन कनेक्ट दोज वायर्स. दिस कंप्लीट प्रोग्रामर सिस्टम हैव अ नेम कॉल्ड STK 200. इन लिस्ट ऑफ प्रोग्रामर जो कि आपको इक्लिप्स में मिला होगा, यू विल ऑल्सो फाइंड अ प्रोग्रामर कॉल्ड STK 200. ये इसी प्रोग्रामर का नाम है. 6 ओनली 4 वायर्स. ग्राउंड को अगर निगलेक्ट करते हैं, वी हैव ओनली 4 वायर्स. दीज 4 वायर्स हैव अ नेम कॉल्ड STK 200. सो यू कैन यूज ओनली 4 वायर्स टू ट्रांसफर योर कोड फ्रॉम कंप्यूटर टू माइक्रो कंट्रोलर. ठीक है, तो टू स्टार्ट विथ यू नीड टू परचेज अ माइक्रो कंट्रोलर एंड दैट्स ऑल. ओके, आप बस इससे कनेक्शन कीजिए एंड यू कैन ट्रांसफर योर कोड. नाउ इफ यू हैव परचेज्ड अ माइक्रो प्रोग्रामर फ्रॉम ब्रिक्स ओनली, नॉट आई डोंट नो अबाउट अदर कंपनीज. इफ यू विल परचेज अ माइक्रो प्रोग्रामर लाइक यूएसबी टीनी, यूएसबी एसपी, हम लोग दो ही चीज बनाते हैं, यूएसबी एसपी एंड यूएसबी टीनी. यू नीड टू कनेक्ट दिस 9 पिन कनेक्टर टू योर माइक्रो कंट्रोलर. फॉर कनेक्शन वी हैव अ कनेक्शन डायग्राम लाइक दिस. ये आपके सीडीज में दिया गया होगा. ये भी नोट कर ले. यू कैन डाउनलोड ऑल सॉफ्टवेयर, ऑल पीपीटीज, ऑल ट्यूटोरियल्स, ऑल सैंपल कोड्स, एवरीथिंग. देयर इज नथिंग हिडन. सब कुछ वहां रखा हुआ है ऑन दिस साइट. सारे सैंपल कोड, सारे ट्यूटोरियल, सारे पीपीटीज, सब कुछ, everything is available on this site, http://ftp.brickswell.com. be careful, ye http hi hona chahiye aur ye ftp hona chahiye. when you will put ftp, the browser will by default change it to ftp, so it should be http. okay, फॉर एनी क्वेरीज यू कैन कॉन्टैक्ट मी एट दिस ईमेल आई डी rshankar@brickswell.com. क्लियर? नो, In your CD, we have provided you a software called SignaProg. Okay, जो कि मैंने first lecture में बताया भी था. Let's see what is this SignaProg. If you will open the folder, you will find a set of files like this. Okay, out of these files, you will have a SignaProg.exe. Clear? If you will run it, it will show you a window like this. In this window, you will have few options. To open a hex file, we have a open button. This is a message box. Flash, EEPROM, device, fusage, programmer. Here you can open your hex file. Hex file कहाँ होती है? आपके work space में किसी folder के अंदर है. Hex file होगी. Okay, you can open that hex file directly or access that hex file directly from here. Flash. If you want to transfer that code hex file from computer to microcontroller, you can write, you can click on this button called program. What it will do? It will transfer the code from computer to microcontroller. In case you just want to verify ki jo code andar gaya hai, wahi code hamare paas, ya hamare paas jo code hai, wahi code andar microcontroller ke bhi hai, you can click on this button called verify. If you want ki sir ne jo microcontroller ko code banaya hai, unke microcontroller mein jo code hai, wo aap chori karke apne microcontroller mein dalna chahte hain, and if you have access to his device, you can click this button read to read a hex file from his microcontroller to your computer. Okay, unke microcontroller se aap apne computer mein hex file transfer kar sakte hain using this button called read. After reading that hex file, you can copy that hex file from computer to some other microcontroller. Clear? You can read a hex file from microcontroller to computer, but you can't get a C code of that hex file. Okay, hex file ka C conversion nahi possible hai. Okay, just because ki hex file itna jada raw mein information hota hai ki usko phir se technical English mein convert karna bahut muskil hota hai. Similar for EEPROM, if you want to write some data on EEPROM, if you want to read data from EEPROM, you can use these buttons. Now, here, device, you can select your microcontroller. Ki kaun sa microcontroller aap code kar rahe hain. You can select it from this drop down menu. Okay, now there is one option called search. If you don't know ki jis bhi device hai, usme aap kisi ne, let's assume ki microcontroller ka naam erase kar diya hai. But you want to check your कौन सा microcontroller है, उसमें access अभी तक है. You can use this button called search to search which microcontroller you have connected to your USB TINI. Okay, if you will click on that search button, वो search करके बता देगा कि कौन सा microcontroller connected है. Okay, next, to change the frequency of your microcontroller, you have this drop down menu facility. 1 megahertz, 2 megahertz, 4 megahertz, 8 megahertz, external crystal. You can select your desired frequency from here. You can select your desired frequency from here and click on program. If you will click on program, it will change the frequency of your microcontroller. Clear? On the background, only we have is commands. So if you want, you can. No. Using C code, there is no option. Okay. In C code, we don't have any option to change the frequency of microcontroller. You have option. No. Only using this button. No. In C code, you can't do anything related to this clock speed. Okay. C code goes to a flash memory. These information are stored in a register called fuse bits, lock bits. Okay, or in simple. Settings, properties, AVR dude, fuses, you will have all these options also, there also. Okay, same, all these settings you can do using Eclipse also. Not in C code, but in Eclipse you have all the facilities. Okay, where you set the programmer name, in same window there are tabs. One tab will be fuses. Here you can see it's written fuses. These, all these information are stored in register name fuse bits. Okay. So unki settings aap wahan se bhi change kar sakte hain. This is a graphical interface, wahan itna acha graphics nahi hai. So but if you are little expert, you can do all those things. No, for all microcontrollers. You can see very long list. Okay, so you can program any programmer, any microcontroller out of these. So all AVR program programmers, no, microcontrollers are there. क्या? Only AVR. मैं जितनी भी चीजें सिखा रहा हूँ, only AVR, AVR. मतलब boundary AVR के अंदर भी नहीं है, बाहर भी नहीं है, only AVR. All AVR and only AVR. Okay? Good. Architecture, just architecture. Architecture means अंदर की electronics like. हाँ, more power. It's a more powerful, more speed, more powerful means much more. What? No, 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 no. Not in terms of this user friendly. Other things like if you want to do image processing, it will be little difficult to do in AVR microcontrollers because of some memory problem, speed problem. But in case of ARM, it works at 32 megahertz, 64 megahertz, and at higher speed. In case of AVR, we have limit of 16 megahertz only. Okay. So in terms of speed, efficiency, ARM is much better than AVR. AVR and PIC, these two have same features in terms of technical technical facilities. AVR have more user friendly, is more user friendly thing. PIC is not that much user friendly.
Ask your questions if you got
it. Huh, if you have any question, you ask me. Okay. So here we can select fuse our frequency of microcontroller and we can program it. Next, here we have list of programmers. Jitne programmers inki list mein hote hain, like STK 500, you will also find STK 200 in this list. Here you can see STK 200. Okay, this. No, STK 500 is from serial port, STK 200 is from parallel port. There are different. Okay, now, whenever you are using a programmer connected to serial port or parallel port, you need to select your serial or parallel port from this menu. Like if you are using a parallel port connection, you need to select the which parallel port. In case of USB, no need to select. USB mein wo janta hai ki kahan hoga. But in case of parallel and serial port, computer will not have any information regarding the device connected on those ports. Aap parallel port pe kuch connect karte hain, to computer ko nahi pata chalta hai. Like in case of USB, jab bhi aap kuch plug karte hain, computer will know ki haan aapne kuch plug kiya. But in case of parallel or serial port, computer ko kabhi pata nahi chalta hai. If you want to transfer, you need to specify the port number or port name. So in my computer, I have only serial, one parallel port, we virtual hai, so it's showing LPT1. If I will have some serial port, it will also show the name of those parallel or serial ports. Okay, so you need to select those also. Now, going to some advanced level. Fuse bits. Fuse bits mein dheer sari information hoti, not only frequency. Other than frequency also, you will have so many features inside your fuse bits. So let's click on this advanced button to see complete features of your fuse bits. When you will click on this advanced button, you will see a new window in front of you. There is a read button. So before making any change in these settings, you must read the default feature from your device. Like here you can see lock bits 00, high fuse 00, low fuse 00, external fuse 00. All these are 0000. If you will make any change and you will write that change in your microcontroller may be dead. Okay, आपने गलत सेटिंग कर दी, it's not dead, but for you it will be dead. Okay, so before making any change in this window, you must know about that change. और नहीं जानते हैं तो ज्यादा से ज्यादा यह होगा कि आपका माइक्रोकंट्रोलर खराब हो जाएगा. ओके, सो लेट्स सी व्हाट आर दोज फीचर्स. लॉक बिट्स. व्हेन वी डिजाइन अ डिवाइस लाइक दिस, हमने इस डिवाइस में कुछ स्पेशल फीचर्स डाले हैं, मैंने मतलब कंपनी ने, एंड कंपनी डोंट वांट कि दूसरी कंपनीज ये डिटेक्ट कर ले कि इसमें कौन सा फीचर्स कैसे डाला गया है. इफ आई विल program this at Mega 16 inside this microcontroller, this device, and will sell in the market. दूसरी companies भी इसे खरीद सकती है, उस microcontroller के अंदर क्या है देख सकती है. Just to avoid this problem, they have something called lock bits. In lock bits, we have a feature to lock my microcontroller. Lock in terms of read, lock in terms of write, lock in terms of everything. आप सब कुछ lock कर सकते हैं. सब कुछ lock करने के बाद it is not possible or it is impossible to read anything from microcontroller, read, write anything to microcontroller or make any change. But the code will run. जो उसके अंदर code पड़ा हुआ है it will run. Other than that you can't do anything. So it will be a, from now it will be a passive device instead of a active device. वो active था पहले, आप जब भी चाहते थे कुछ change कर लेते थे, नई चीज़ बना लेते थे, कुछ इनोवेटिव बना लेते थे, कुछ सिंपल बना लेते थे, बट आफ्टर दैट लॉक इट विल बी अ फाइनल डिवाइस. उसके बाद उसमें कोई चेंज नहीं कर सकते. ओके, सो फॉर दैट वी हैव लॉक बिट्स. इफ यू विल क्लिक ऑन दिस सी बटन, यू विल सी अ ड्रॉप डाउन मेन्यू टू सेलेक्ट ऑल दीज फीचर्स, कि आप क्या लॉक करना चाहते हैं. ओके, जस्ट बाय सेलेक्टिंग दिस फीचर्स फ्रॉम ड्रॉप डाउन मेन्यू, यू कैन मेक चेंजेस इन योर bits. Like I have selected, now you can see कि यहाँ lock bits में 03 आ गया. Okay, वो एक byte है, 8 bit का number है, उसमें वो number लिख जाता है, उन्हीं number के according सारी settings define होती है. Okay, so this is called lock bit. High fuse and low fuse, इनमें अलग अलग तरह के features होते हैं. Like, मैं सब कुछ explain नहीं करूँगा, but I will explain few things. On chip debug enable, JTAG interface enable, serial program downloading enable. I don't know about these other things. On chip debug, for debug using JTAG, you need to enable this feature. To use JTAG for any purpose, you need to enable this feature. ISP. ISP is also a feature of that microcontroller which can be enabled or disabled. ISP जिसके थ्रू हम कोड कंप्यूटर से माइक्रोकंट्रोलर में ट्रांसफर कर रहे हैं, दैट फीचर कैन बी इनेबल और डिसेबल यूजिंग दिस क्लिक. सो इफ यू विल परचेज अ माइक्रोकंट्रोलर, न्यू माइक्रोकंट्रोलर फ्रॉम मार्केट, यू नीड टू डिसेबल दिस JTAG फीचर टू यूज दोज 4 पिंस फ्रॉम सी पोर्ट. ओके, आप यहां से उसको डिसेबल कर सकते हैं. इसको अनचेक कीजिए, ओके कीजिए, एंड प्रोग्राम वो डिसेबल हो जाएगा. बट नेवर डिसेबल दिस ISP, और हियर इट्स रिटन SPI. SPI को अगर आपने डिसेबल कर दिया तो क्या होगा, यू हैव लॉस्ट द लिंक बिटवीन माइक्रोकंट्रोलर एंड योर कंप्यूटर. सो इट विल नॉट बी पॉसिबल टू डू एनीथिंग यूजिंग ISP. उसके बाद उसे वो STK 500 जो 6000 की का बोर्ड आता है उस पर डालना होगा. दैट बोर्ड विल बी एबल टू एक्सेस द इंटरनल रजिस्टर्स ऑफ माइक्रोकंट्रोलर यूजिंग सम डिफरेंट इंटरफेस. उसके थ्रू फिर आप इसको इनेबल कर सकते हैं SPI को, और फिर SPI इनेबल हो गया तो आप नॉर्मल SPI के थ्रू कम्युनिकेशन कर सकते हैं. ओके, सो कभी कभार होता है ऐसा है कि प्रोग्राम करते समय या किसी प्रॉब्लम के कारण SPI डिसेबल हो जाता है तो आपका माइक्रोकंट्रोलर काम करना बंद कर देगा. ओके, इन दैट कंडीशन यू कैन से कि हाँ हमारा माइक्रोकंट्रोलर खराब हो गया, बट इन एक्चुअल वो खराब नहीं हुआ होता है, उसके सिर्फ एक फीचर डिसेबल हो गया है. एंड सो ऑन, यू हैव डिफरेंट फीचर्स, यू कैन सेलेक्ट डिफरेंट फीचर फ्रॉम हेयर एंड यू कैन मेक सेटिंग्स हेयर. In high fuse, low fuse, you will have your microcontroller's clock setting. Here you can see internal RC oscillator 1 MHz, startup time 6 clock plus 0 millisecond.
internal clock RC oscillator 1 megahertz, startup time 6 clock 4 millisecond. And we have different options, similar for 2 megahertz, 3 megahertz, 4 megahertz. So whatever option you want, you can also select from here. Okay. And so on, you have few more features. External fuse. For high level microcontroller, like at Mega 128, there are few more features jo ki yahan se extra fuse, external fuses se control kiye jate hain. Okay. Here we have option to erase the chip. If you will click on this erase chip, it will erase the code written on your microcontroller. Okay. So this was the story of extra thing for your microcontroller. Next, 2 minute ki cheeze bachi hai, wo bhi bata deta hu. Next, till now we have learned how to use a library called avr/io.h. उसके कुछ फीचर्स हमने देखे, उसमें कोई फंक्शन नहीं होता है. वी विल हैव ओनली डिफिनीशंस, डिफिनीशन ऑफ पोर्ट ए, पिन ए, DDRA एंड सो ऑन अदर रजिस्टर्स. सारे रजिस्टर्स जो होते हैं उसमें डिफाइंड होते हैं. ओके. डिले डॉट एच हमने यूज किया, उसमें दो फंक्शंस थे. एग्जैक्टली सिमिलर टू दीज टू लाइब्रेरी वी हैव 10 to 20 मोर लाइब्रेरीज. ओके. If you want to know about those library, if you want to use the functions inside those library, you must have list of all those things. If you want to see the list, just go to your start menu, all programs, WinAVR. In WinAVR, you will see a link called AVR libc manual. AVR libc manual. Open that manual. Inside this manual, you will find complete description of your compiler. आपका compiler कैसे काम करता है, वो किस चीज को किस तरह से optimize करता है, कब किस variable को delete कर देगा, किस variable को कहाँ store करता है. All technical details, if you know about compiler, you will find all those details in this file. ओके. कंपाइलर का कंप्लीट डिटेल दिया जाता है कि कंपाइलर कैसे वर्क कर रहा है, वो किस तरह से किस चीजों को कैसे ऑप्टिमाइज करता है. ओके. ऑल दोज थिंग्स यू विल हैव इन दिस पेज. नाउ इफ यू गो वांट टू सी द लाइब्रेरी, देयर इज अ लिंक कॉल्ड लाइब्रेरी रेफरेंसेस, रेफरेंस. इफ यू विल क्लिक ऑन दिस, यू विल सी द लिस्ट ऑफ ऑल द लाइब्रेरीज. Here you can see कि सारी libraries दिखाई गई है. Okay. Now, मैंने बताया था how to write and read from EEPROM. If you want to learn how to read and write data in EEPROM, you will find the detail inside this library. Here. We have list of functions 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We have 8 functions using which we can read and write from EEPROM. 4 read functions hai, 4 write functions hai. Let's see ki difference kya hai. Actually ek hi read, ek hi write hai. First, EEPROM read byte. Here you need to provide the address. Address means if you have a, let's say 500 bytes, 5 नहीं होता है, 500 नहीं होता है, 512 bytes size है आपके EEPROM का, you will have address starting from 0 to 511. Okay,